to take the pictures of your garments that we will use to digitize in the software. I just want to give you a few tips to help you along the way. To start, again, just a reminder, you can do a paper pattern, which is probably a good idea. It's going to be a little bit easier, or a garment. So once you have that gone that far and know what you're going to do, make sure you have a list of each pattern piece. So in this case, for this dress, there's a front, there's a back, and there's a sleeve. So be real clear, like, that, okay, I need to take three good pictures, one of each pattern piece, and that pattern needs to be flat. So another thing I recommend having handy is maybe some measuring tape or a ruler, or it might not be a bad idea to make like a little reference square. This I cut out of paper. It's 2 inches by 2 inches, and I'm just going to place it on my garment so that I know here's a box that's 2 inches. Having a measuring tape on it basically does the same thing, or a ruler as well. So just have something so you have a point of reference to know the actual size of the garment in your photograph. Okay, so now I'm going to start with piece number one, which is my front. So I just want to make sure I lay the front as flat as possible. In order to get the front flat, this sleeve has to move. It's not working. You can see on the left here, the sleeve's down. I'm not going to get a good read of the pattern over here on my right, the wearer's left. But when I move the sleeve and I make sure the pattern's flat, and you really want to pay attention to your grain line, so make sure you are familiar with the term grain line. If not, I can put a link to talk more about that. But that's really the direction of your fabric. A lot of times with your yarns, you can see them going up and down. Once you train your eye to really find that grain line, in this case, it's a denim twill, so you kind of see a diagonal line, but you'll just know if your fabric's twisted or not. Get as flat as you can. That will help you, I know what shape you need for like the armhole and whatnot, and what shape for the slope of the shoulder, and then even the silhouette of the side seam. And it looks like we have a straight hem here. So laying it flat, you'll be good. Have your marker, that's good. Make sure your camera is parallel to the floor. We don't want it tilted. And I have an example of a photo where I did a bad tilt. Let me pull up this one. Click, click, there it goes. So here, this is not a good photo to try to digitize because we have some foreshortening problems. Like now all of a sudden the hem is way wider and bigger than what we have down here, and the neckline is really small. So you have to be really careful with the way you hold your camera. Your camera really needs to be flat, like to the floor again, from it. It cannot be tilted at all. So that's a big deal. So here's like a better picture. Back to the good one. Again, here, I threw on some measuring tape. You can kind of do either or if you have the little chip. Okay, another challenge you're going to find if you choose a garment, you can avoid this if you choose a paper pattern, is you're going to have to deal with darts, darts and pleats. So in this case, I have a pleat. This is a little bit more intermediate, and we're all going to have totally different projects, so this is a hard one to lecture for everybody. But again, I can see my grain line going up down in here, and I see it here. And so I would just measure the width of your dart. This photo does not measure the width of it. Kind of measures the length, but that's not really important. Let me go to this one. Double click there. Here, I put my measuring tape inside. It looks like it's about like 2 1/4 inches deep. So I'm just going to have to do some math when I get to the computer to like slash and spread my pattern. So this is a little intermediate. So if you're not up for that, don't do it. Just get a paper pattern and we'll focus on digitizing it. And we can do some of this intermediate stuff a little bit later in the semester. But if you feel like I can handle it and I really want to make something in my closet that's cute, go ahead. I actually rent dresses from Rent the Runway, so I can like knock off stuff that I don't own, which is kind of neat. So anyways, side note, so that's really it. Just get some really good photos. Make sure you have some kind of measuring tool. Make sure you're mindful of the pattern pieces you need, the names of them, and that as you take a picture of each piece, it's laid flat. You know where the grain line is. Nothing's twisted or wrinkled, and you should be good to then digitize it.